So like in entrepreneurs, right, let's talk more about this. How do you think importance of ethics is? You know, we see businesses doing the wrong things behind the curtains, you know. How much do you think, according to your business journey, how much importance should one give to ethics and ethical background?
It's not how much.
Yeah,
it you can do business only if you have that right
ethics,
thing.
Ethics, right. Yeah.
There's no compromise. I told you earlier, there's no compromise.
Right. Yeah.
And ethics is the main thing. You can't do how, including paying income tax. It should not. You see, what I'm trying to say is that
right.
They are charging more or less is a different point.
Right.
But you don't try to break law.
Got it.
You don't try to break people's faith.
Got it.
That's why I said when you see anything you do, it may not be directly to the consumer. Mm-hmm. It could be to business to business.
Right.
You need to be honest to them, right? They are
right.
paying for your services. You are creating something.
Right.
It could be any of the service what you do
right.
or any of the product you do.
Mm.
There is a consumer.
Right.
There is a so you need to be trustworthy and you can't be compromising on moral grounds or any grounds for that.
Right.
So there is no excuse for that.
Right. Sir, I want to talk about, you know, you as a person have inspired me a lot according to what you did in the country with theme parks. But I'd like to ask you, you know, when you were the first one doing it, you know, because you don't have someone's work to look back at and see, okay, this is the way I'll go about it. Who are the people from your childhood till, you know, when you did films to today? Who are the some of the people who influenced you or who inspired you to do more and to dream audaciously like you do?
See, there are two major things which I did was one
right.
of the cinemas
hmm.
and one was the park.
Park, yeah.
Like you visit, first of all, wherever you travel, I always make it a point to see a theme park there.
Right.
Australia or wherever.
This is before you created your...
Yeah.
Imagine.
82, right? I visited the first Disney in.
Right. Oh,
I
got it.
I did it in 2009.
Right.
I started working on it.
Right.
So it takes time to something right. which in mind you want to do it.
Uh-huh.
I would say, see, in the processing laboratory business, I would look up to Ramesh Prasad.
Hmm.
The Prasad Labs. At
got
that time,
it.
Very large in the south.
Right, yeah.
I wanted to have their status in the north and
got
north
it.
Like that.
Yeah.
I won't call him he's a friend, so I won't call him a role model, but you know, he had achieved much early stage because of his father having a laboratory,
got
which I didn't have.
Sure, got
so
it.
He had the, so it
early
looked like
again,
that.
Yeah.
Otherwise, I think it's very difficult to say, for example, we were doing a theme park for the first time in the country.
Right.
What will you make?
Right.
You have seen so many things in the US or somewhere, but is the Indian audience will accept it or
right.
not?
Yeah.
So, I'm sure my daughter worked a lot on the creative, this on Aarti on that.
Right.
So what we said, how do you do? So we picked up the best attractions in various parks
and
tried to
it.
Pick that up and to Indianize it.
Right.
For example, there is a ride of similar kind, but we made it like Mr. India.
Mr. India, right.
Right. There is a soaring with Disney. We said
right.
we, Eye for India. And we shot all over the country
right.
on helicopter.
Yeah.
Like that, any attraction if you see, there is a reference point to it that you know this is the kind of this
right.
Only other attraction I wanted to do was Transformers, but I ran out of my budget. So
right.
other things, I think we have done a good job in terms of selecting what is good.
Definitely.
To try to answer your question about is there a role model or what do you do it? Is it because the role model was what is popular attractions all over the world
right.
and we picked up from that.
Right.
Which we could do.
Have so this about business and how you got inspired by others' business. But is there in life a few role models that you follow or you think young people should really read about or know about?
I have not done that in
right.
my life. So I'm sure they should read
right
to get a faster understanding of
got.
This one. It could be a family head. It could be a writer in the overseas
right.
or
right.
I have not
got it.
So it's like reading Bible.
Hmm.
So you can
right.
or Ramayana or Mahabharata, whatever.
Right. Sir, I'd like to ask you this question, like if, you know, given a chance to change something in your life going back, is there something that you think you would change or do differently or, you know, do like do something that you didn't have a chance to do?
You see, you are learning every day.
Right.
And if you learn and if you don't correct yourself or improve yourself or grade yourself upper.
Right.
there is no sense in passing through, you know, on learning or reading or seeing a film, anything like that.
Right.
You definitely learn and you should correct yourself.
Right.
But how important it is a different point. But if I have given a choice today to make a park again,
right,
I would do it differently because I would use this experience what happened to this park.
Right, exactly.
I would do that.
Uh-huh.
It's like a filmmaker saying, yaar, mera galti ho gaya film mein, I will correct myself in the next film. So I would also do that. And because we are all, we should be learning every day. Uh-huh. You are learning in your age, I am learning in my age, what I am seeing and what I am reading. So it's a, what I will do differently, I can definitely tell you about the park.
Uh-huh.
Otherwise, I think I have done a good job in terms of the laboratory, theaters, films, distribution.
Uh-huh.
I think I have done a good job, and that's a role model for others to see.
Right. So, in the park thing, is there a few things you'd like to list that you'd have done differently now?
That we realize that India is not ready to pay that kind of price. Right. I would make a lesser,
cheaper, and less infrastructure.
Yeah. Less infrastructure and make it in different places in the country, then make it in one place.
Right.
Thinking that it can become Disney of the country. Because see, the cost of traveling today from Delhi to Bombay or Indore to Bombay or Dehradun to Bombay, in the same cost, they can travel to Hong Kong or Dubai or Singapore.
Got it.
Because of the airline cost and the package deal they get. So why would they come to Bombay? So the country is outbound tourism. It's not inbound tourism.
Right.
I was expecting it to be tourism becomes, I am a mega tourism project.
Right.
And you must have heard, even the prime ministers keep talking about tourism, and the government is not doing anything about tourism.
Right.
So it's a private person, people cannot keep struggling in industry. So you see, very strangely, if you see that, you know, every state central government has a tourism ministry.
Right.
And today's thankfully prime minister is talking about, you know, tourism has to improve. Yeah. And every state government has a tourism and a ministry of that kind. God knows what they are doing. For example, Maharashtra is only selling temples and Elephanta Caves and Ajanta Ellora, which is the nature has given you.
Right.
What are, to sell what is nature has given you, you don't need ministry. If you have ministry and budgets, you should be creating something.
Something, right.
For the people to
creating
come.
Creating new attractions.
New thing for as a tourism.
Right.
So, which is not there. Not
happening. Yeah.
So, it's not happening in the whole country.
Hmm.
In spite of, and hopefully they'll work on it, but I don't want to blame anybody, but they should do something more.
Yeah. But that's not happening as of now. Yeah. So you, in my terms, are, you know, very visionary, right? You saw something like theme parks coming in India, you hopped on the train, you did that with IMAX, with Multiplexes. I would like to ask you, when, you know, as a 17 and a half year old boy, when you came to Mumbai, what was your vision then? What was your vision when you were trying to create a Imagica, and what is your vision now when you have created a state of art theme park in this country? What is your next step, and is it a conscious effort to do something more than that, which I can see in your work though still?
No, when I came to Bombay, as I told you, it's only survival instinct. That, you know, you need to survive. You can't go back home and there's nothing there, so you just have to work or do something.
Right.
Over the period of time,
uh-huh.
when you achieve something, what you're doing it. Right. Then I should have a flat.
Right.
Then I should have a car.
Right.
Then I should get married.
Right.
So, these are the
more
basic
cars,
norms.
More,
So when you achieve that, then you think, what do I do now?
Right.
Do I have a potential to do something else?
Right.
I could have a bank employee and retired in 60, probably.
Yeah.
I could have a school teacher.
Got it.
Actually, that's what my father was trying to make me when I was not a good student.
Right.
So my father said in our hometown, said you should become a teacher only, because nothing else you can do. You're not good at.
Right.
So anyway, so you could, but you achieve that, then you say, what do I do now?
Right.
So if you don't have potential, you will retire like a school teacher, you will retire like a bank clerk or something like that. People do that.
Right.
But that's what you should be doing. You should, if there is some talent in you, then you should be able to do it. And of course, you are right place, right time, the luck has to favor you, all those things has to happen.
Right.
But have you put enough efforts that what I want to do? Are you ambitious?
Right.
See, ambition only killed people also, but that's what the success also.
Right.
So, ambition has to be there.
That's great.
You are, that every ambitious guy may not be successful.
Mm.
But that's what I'm saying. That's where it comes, you know, luck being in the right place, right
You have
time.
To like at least yeah. put in the work yeah. followed by your ambition.
You have to do that. Initial work, you have to do that.
Right. Well, like what's your vision now going further with Adlabs Entertainment or Imagica?
The best thing I'm enjoying at the present time
right.
is that I'm enjoying my tennis game. I enjoy my drink right. and I see a film each day.
Wow.
Evening. This is so I just want to come out of my financial
this
one from the park
huh.
and I'll think of something new. I'm not right. too sure what I'll do, but I think I'll not be able to keep quiet
right.
as far as the health right. is permitting me,
which is very great, you know. Being in the present moment and living a day by itself is something is a huge lesson in entrepreneurship as well. Do you think
yeah, because
so?
You can't let it go. Oh,
yeah.
mar gaya
ho
gaya abhi kya hoga usse kya hoga nahi hoga. It will actually bother your health.
Right.
So you should live by the day.
Got it.
Because I have not done anything wrong.
Right.
You know, what is happening is that have you done anything wrong in your life? You know what happened? That can become a
right.
conscious.
You keep judging yourself. Yes, then, yeah.
I have done anything. I have done something good for the people.
Hmm.
Always. I put stake my money,
right.
my resources, everything to right. that. So if that doesn't work, well, God bless
you. Do you think you will be investing more in the situated Imagica to improve it or to
that is that's what I'm saying. I need yeah. to come out of the situation present what we right. have financially.
Mm.
Then only we can think. Otherwise, you even if I think,
hmm.
I'll not be able to execute it.
Right. So. Right. So in that also, so I'd like to ask you, you know, if there's someone, you know, around the country who is watching this and who wants to dream big and achieve big, you know, and do something which will help the country, which will put the country on a new pedestal, but as well as, you know, be like real huge dreams. What would you like to tell those people and how to go about it?
See, I've been only in media and entertainment industry. Right.
right?
So in that particular space,
hmm.
it is exposed everything.
Right.
You are learning here
right.
what you should be doing to the future
right.
on entertainment. So what right. happens? You can make films
hmm.
bigger and better and right. larger.
Hmm.
But there could be smaller films also which right. could be made to what people
right.
identify
right.
and see.
Got it.
But otherwise for me to say today is, do you think that there should be larger
hmm.
theme park business? Or larger television business, or larger OTT business.
Hmm.
So much potential is there to do anything.
In
anybody can do
least,
anything.
Yeah.
You can do it. And there are a lot of things. If, for example, somebody is putting so much money in doing one film
right.
or one OTT platform, mm-hmm. with same thing you can do because the technology available at such a lower
right.
price.
Uh-huh.
You probably can do it at half the cost or one third
right.
of the cost.
Right, right.
But if you focus on content, what people want to see. See, just say, let's try to understand the consumer.
Right.
You provide something which you want to consume, that's the achievement what you have, I think, sure. Because you don't have a problem with the people.
Uh-huh.
And I don't have the problem with the people paying for it.
Uh-huh.
So, it's like the phones.
right.
Every member of the country has the phone you've never imagined.
Uh-huh. Got it.
A few years ago.
Right.
You have. So, every he is your consumer now
mm-hmm.
in terms of entertainment.
Mm-hmm.
Media, even in the news item, for example, he is
right.
going to be looking into that on
right.
your phone.
Right.
So you see a lot of potential to do anything. Do you have that creative urge
uh-huh.
and potential?
Uh-huh.
That's what it is.
You know, with this young entrepreneurship culture here, do you think that entrepreneurs should, like people should pursue entrepreneurship or like, because as a 17,
I think the whole Prime Minister himself is doing
right.
startup
uh-huh.
and startup. He's
right.
trying to tell you every individual has a potential to become an entrepreneur.
Exactly, right.
Actually, it was not like that.
Right. Which
out of the 100, one guy comes right. and he is called as an entrepreneur.
Right.
It's not so.
Right.
He's actually telling and probably
everyone should. Yeah.
Every person is potentially entrepreneur today.
Right, right.
Because that much technology is available for
right.
you to show your
mm-hmm.
Talent.
Mm-hmm.
So it could be anybody, everybody could be an entrepreneur and they should be. I have just come from a village which is
right.
remote kind of a thing. It's still remote place if I go back there. So because that place is not improved.
Right.
So and if I can do what
so yeah, much, yeah.
Look at Subhashji, Whistling Woods, he also come from somewhere
yeah.
unknown.
A village, yeah.
Right.
Mm.
So people have come from this one. You don't need a place to be bigger. Mm. And there are a lot of stories of that kind. Well, so, and I think everybody has a potential to be an entrepreneur.
Definitely, definitely. So, sir, in this, like, you know, last few questions, in the journey, when you were doing so much and working so hard, did sometime you feel that, I think this is not going to happen? Or I think I have, you know, chewed off too much, like, I've bit off too much than I can chew?
No, it did not happen to me. Even when I was doing a theme park,
right,
that is the largest project I've done. Nobody has done in this country, I still claim that. Till I opened park, I was not, I was very happy that I achieved it and I,
right.
There was no, but why is it, when the park started going into, there is a depression, you know, like, you know, lost situation.
Mm.
Why people are not coming to see, which is, whoever comes there is so happy that they have, the park is so good.
Right.
Even today, after the 7th year, people who have come now say it's fantastic, I never knew. So, why people are not coming, that much number what we want to do.
Right.
That is a lost situation.
Uh-huh.
Otherwise, I have not seen any minus points in my career.
Right. How do you overcome with situations like that? You know, when you think a product is valuable and that good, that everyone should consume it, but it doesn't happen that way. How do you think one should? Because I know that there will be young entrepreneurs who are seeing this and would create a product that they put out in the market and people wouldn't react.
It's very difficult in today's time to say. I'll tell you why most of the large companies are in distress today. Why they could be in a distress?
Right.
How many companies are in distress today?
Right.
They're all doing well in the last 5 years, 10 years.
Uh-huh.
Something has gone wrong in people's mind, or technology driven businesses, or whatever. They have become obsolete in technology, or something has happened. So it's very difficult to say that, you know, what is right to do. And you are an entrepreneur, you are trying to put up a service product or a product or anything, or an institution, but it may fail.
Right.
But that provision you have to keep in your mind, that, you know, we can fail you have a stake in that.
Right.
It's not only your time. It is the
money
and people's time,
efforts,
everything is
there.
That can fail because there is a competitor who has come in half the cost of yours.
Right.
So he's providing.
So you should be ready to fail when you are getting into the race.
It is not possible that I am an entrepreneur, so anything I do has to work.
Right. So you should be. Do you think
all those startups by then started about this, like Flipkart and all those small companies are all failed? No. You had a .com problem in 2000. So happened, no? So everybody, though, Silicon Valley said India is the only place which can do that.
Right.
But it didn't happen. See? It failed. Failure is always there.
Right. So
it doesn't mean that you should not stop. You should stop dreaming.
So when you fail, you should go on to do something else, and you know.
That's at that particular time you need to decide.
Right.
It's very difficult to say that
personally. Take the
maybe it will, if you could sustain that business, it will give you some more thing after
definitely
some time.
It's a subjective cost.
It's at that particular time you need to
decide. Right. Awesome. Awesome. So, you know, that's all for the episode. I'd like you to ask the last question for today. And if you could, like, go through all your memories and answer this one, is that what is, according to you, like the success mantra one should have? Because you came, like as you said, from a village, and there are people who know who have those big dreams. What do you think one habit or thing or anything, one success mantra that you think you kept within you or within your subconscious that made you come here?
I don't know. I just wanted to achieve. Now, it also depends on your ambitions, for example.
Wow.
What is my ambition? The regular life, you know, you want to be good and not to be known for your work. Suppose my ambition was, I need to own a ship and two planes and this one. So, I am a failure.
Right.
See, if my business will not give that.
Right.
Suppose I had an ambition. This one is in, when I am 40, I should have this. I won't have achieved it. So, I would have been a failure. So, failure success is the mind, what the ambition what you have. Why do you want to? Everybody should own planes. It's not possible, right?
Right.
So, my ambition was that I need to be successful and comfortable, and that I have achieved. So,
awesome.
But I have done something which people can see even today.
Right.
That how did this Multiplexes came? How did this IMAX came? And how Adlabs Imagica came?
Yeah.
So, I have done that. So, it is not necessarily a very financially comfortable situation.
Right.
But it, I wanted to create a job. Yeah. I achieved
the creation is that.
So everybody can have that. But as I'll come back to say that every entrepreneur, every individual who is youngster who is doing it, try to be honest, fair,
right,
good,
right,
hardworking.
Right.
Then try to be at the right place.
Right. I really like, you know, the way you said that I just wanted to achieve, and which I think is the whole crux of your journey, that you dreamt big and you always thought you could achieve. And that has got you places. Amazing.
So I'll just it's like, you know, when you do a theme park,
right,
you're doing so many things at where money is involved. Then one is acquiring land.
Right.
You try to acquire land anywhere in the country.
Right.
There are so many litigations going on the land.
Right.
So many things are there. So I was always thinking that I committed to the banks and borrowed money into that.
And it's a 300 acre land.
And there is a problem with the licenses. And there's a government is involved, the local bodies involved. There are projects stopped by the local people objecting to it.
Wow.
You know, there are so many projects you must have heard.
Right.
The guy has done the project,
uh-huh,
and the local people have objected to it. So,
right.
So there were 10 things that have gone wrong,
right,
in this project. And I had a 1700 crore rupees
risk. Debt.
But nothing went wrong or whatever. Everything fall in line and I completed the project. That itself is a great achievement.
Right. It is, definitely.
So, because otherwise it can stop, no?
Right.
So, imagine you are on the 60% of the project. Something goes wrong. What happens? Everything goes wrong, right? So, I achieved on that.
Definitely. You
and
know.
I'm very happy with the product, but people, I think they will take some more time to have more
performance. Definitely. I feel, you know, I remember visiting Imagica, you know, last year, I guess, I visited Imagica, and that was the first time I had visited it, because we used to go around, but we didn't visit Imagica. But I remember visiting it and seeing it, and I was blown out. I was like, I've seen nothing like this in this country ever before. You know, I remember sitting in Nitro and all of those rides, and I was like, this is something out of this world, you know, something
that's
on the standards
I wanted to
of
create,
Disney.
So
yeah, exactly. Yes. And which is a huge success, you know. So yeah, if you are watching, do visit Imagica, and yeah. That's all for the session today, sir. Thank you for being on the show
today. Thank you for having me.
Your story is definitely inspiring, and I am quite sure that everyone who is watching is inspired by sir's story. I'll link sir's handles down below. Go watch him. There are some interviews that I'd like of sir's that you would go and watch. So do that. So yeah, till time we meet again, stay healthy, stay awesome, do some awesome stuff. Remember that you're one of your kind. Live a kick-ass life. Be kind to one another. And on that note, farewell, mates.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.